this story is gonna be about how I was in a trap house. Y'all, for real, for real, for real. Like, this is serious here. So my boyfriend was moving into his new place, and when he first moved into the place, he didn't necessarily know his roommates, and he didn't know that much about his roommates. Of course, when you first get roommates, you're not gonna necessarily know everything about them. Now, I wasn't always at my boyfriend's place. Some days I wouldn't be over there, some days I would be over there. One day when I was over there, my boyfriend, he was leaving to go to work, and I stayed in his room. I decided to stay. I think I was finishing homework, doing whatever I was doing. I stayed in his room and I was just chilling there, watching TV, chilling till he came back, you know, his home, my home, Mukasa, Mikasa. Now, before this actually occurred, me and Caleb did find out that they did sell drugs. Like, it was a trap house. All three of them were selling drugs. All three of them were working together. They were drug dealers. They sold them in and out of the house. And they would, of course, smoke weed as well. I was just chilling in the room, minding my own. And then I hear a bunch of noise. I hear somebody bust in. I hear arguments. And I didn't know who was arguing. I didn't see any of this. I'm in the room with the door locked. And I'm just in the room hearing everything go on. I was kind of scared. I was, because I heard a gunshot. Yes, I did. I heard a gunshot. Y'all wanna know what I did? I hid under the bed. Once I heard a gunshot, I went under the bed because I'm like, they may know that I'm in the room. They may bust up in the room and tell me not to say anything. I don't know. It sounded like there was about three or four people in the actual living room area doing all of this. I heard people encouraging the fight. Goodness, I heard names being thrown out there. Somebody did somebody wrong, clearly. And I didn't know what to do. I didn't pick up the phone and call the police or anything. I think the first thing that I did was go under the bed with my phone. And I remember texting Caleb just to let him know how ratchet his roommate was being and that I was under the bed scared. Some of you guys probably would have called the police, but see, if you look at the news and take a back and really look at what's going on in the world, you wouldn't necessarily think that a police officer would necessarily be somebody, you know, like a hero right now. Nowadays, when you look at the world, the police are attacking the innocent. So, I mean, hello, I wasn't about to call the police, please. I ain't trying to even be involved with the police or the situation that was going on. I was just trying to stay to myself and protect myself. Because honestly, out here, just protect yourself. Some people would have hid under the bed like me, because with gunshots, you never know. Like, people get popped through walls and doors. And I'm not trying to, no, I ain't trying to die, y'all. I am not trying to die. Not only am I not trying to die, I'm not trying to die young. I'm only 24 years old. I want kids. I'm trying to reach 100,000 subscribers. By the way, make sure to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and give this video a thumbs up if you are still watching this video. But that is what happened to me. It was a scary situation. They were still fighting in the living room, and eventually people left, and then I was by myself. And I just stayed in the room until Caleb came back. I didn't stay under the bed the whole entire time, but just really making sure, looking out the window, just to be sure that nothing else was gonna happen while I was there. Another crazy event that happened with this trap house, with these guys in this trap house. Me and Caleb left. We went to go get some food. And then we came back and the cops were out in the front yard, and me and Caleb were just kind of like, should we go in or should we stay in the car? Because once again, I mean, who could really trust the popo? We weren't there when everything went down, but we did get out the car and we did go in. The police officers immediately was all up in our face, all up in our grill, already just doing the most. We let the officers know that, hey, he lives here, I'm the girlfriend, we just came back, we weren't here, we don't know what's going on. So even though we told the police officer that we weren't here, we don't know what's going on, and we weren't involved in whatever was going on, he still told us to sit in the living room with all the rest of these people that were involved. Like, why? Like, for what? You saw, we just pulled up. You see, we got food. You see, he has a beautiful girlfriend that, too cute to be involved in whatever's going on. Me and Caleb sat on the couch, and there were a group of girls that were there that were just going off. They were just pissed. One of the guys were doing tats illegally, so that was that situation. And I think the girls were in the room with him. Not only that, there were also the other two roommates involved because they had drugs out in the open. I don't even know all the detail. All I know is I saw drugs laid out in front of me clearly, and I'm just really upset because the police officers were threatening everybody, like, well, you know, you can get kicked out of school for this. Give me your campus ID, your student ID. And it took so much time. It was just like, man, we should have never got out the car. We should have never came back just to be involved with this. It's just whack. Eventually, they left us alone. Me and Caleb went to Caleb's room, and we just ate our cold Bojangles because it was cold because we was just waiting. I was too upset to eat. You know when you just too upset to eat, to talk, to think? That was me. I didn't even want to go back out there and go to the microwave to warm it up. I just wanted to stay away. I was just like, you know what? I eat it cold. Everybody know if your Supremes are cold, you can't put them in a microwave because they ain't going to be crunchy anymore. They're going to be all kind of soggy, and I don't like that. That's not cool. I don't pay money to have soggy food. I pay money to have crunchy food. So that is my story about how I was in a trap house. I could have been shot. Goodness, how I was threatened by the police. Like, they seriously were really trying to scare people. And I'm like, look, I'm innocent, so say what you want. I ain't going down for everybody problems, okay? I just came up. I just showed up, okay? That's it. I am done here. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to give me a thumbs up. You already know I would really appreciate it. And I will talk to you guys in my next video. I guess that's just my dream.